What's going on, everybody? Today I'm going to be showing you the theory behind why you would wire in a relay to your FZ6. This applies to any vehicle though, in principle. You'd wire in a relay to your FZ6 to add auxiliary equipment like heated grips, auxiliary lights, or a phone charger. The purpose of an added relay on your FZ6 like this one here would be to give another circuit for your new device to draw current from so that you're not overloading an existing circuit on your motorcycle. A relay can seem complicated on the surface, but we're going to dive into the few wires you need to connect to your relay to make it work flawlessly. So let's get into it. First, we're going to look at a schematic about the wires that make the connections between your existing bike and battery to the new relay you're going to add. So looking at the relay diagram, you can see we have an inline fuse coming off the battery positive leading to both the switch and pin 30 on the relay. Pin 30 is the high power feed. This is what's going to send power to your accessory like your lights or heated grips. The other wire going up the top here to the C side of the switch is what's going to trigger the relay to send power to the accessory. Pin 85 here is what receives that signal when the switch is closed. And pin 86 on the left is what grounds that signal back to your battery negative. When your switch closes and sends power to pin 85, which gets grounded back to the battery, it closes the relay and sends power from pin 30 across to pin 87, which results in turning on your accessory. Pin 87 is used when your circuit is run normally open, as in when the bike's resting, the relay is open and not conducting power. In the opposite of that, you could send your power out of 87A, which would be for a normally closed circuit. For our application, we'll be using circuit 87 because we want the relay to be open when the bike's off, and we want it to be closed when it gets a signal from pin 85 to turn on the relay and turn on the power to the accessory. Here I have a little breadboard circuit set up so you can illustrate a relay circuit. The red line is our positive side of the battery, and it's all connected end to end along this outer edge here. This black wire where it comes in the negative from the 9V is our negative line, and it's all connected end to end along the stripe. These little rows of 5 here are all connected individually, not across the middle. So each row is connected in this direction, not this way. When I touch this red wire to the right side, pin 85 of our relay, we turn on the LED. On the switch side of the circuit, this is what's happening when we turn on the LED. Battery positive power is coming in and leaving out this red wire here, entering the relay at pin 85, leaving on pin 87. It comes out the yellow wire here to our negative strip and returns back to battery negative. That's what closes the relay and causes it to make the clicking noise you hear. On your power side, battery power is coming in here, leaving the yellow wire traveling to the bottom pin of the relay, which is pin 30. When the relay is shut by sending power across the two sides of the relay, power leaves out the top on pin 87, travels down to the breadboard through a resistor just to make sure the LED doesn't blow up, through the LED, through the little jumper wire here, and back to battery negative. Here you can see that happening. This LED just is a representation of any accessory device. This could be your heated grips, your accessory lights, whatever it is. It's simply showing you that you're getting power flowing out of pin 87 on the relay. When picking a relay, ensure you pick one that's rated for enough current you plan on putting through it. This one's rated for around 40 to 30 amps at a maximum and 12 volts DC. That'll be plenty for running heated grips, auxiliary lights, or a phone charger for sure. Now in this example here, we're manually triggering the relay, as you would if you had a switch you had to flick on and off. But the benefit of a relay is you can have another circuit on the bike trigger the trigger side of the relay and turn on your accessory circuit. For example, you could use the headlight circuit on the FZ6 to turn on this side of the relay and provide power here once the bike is running, because the headlight will only turn on once the bike is running. This way, if your headlight's off, your relay's off. And if your relay's off, the accessory that's driven by the relay is also off. So it's a fail-safe way of ensuring that whatever accessory you hook up to this relay is also off with the rest of the bike. If you were to hook up the trigger side of the relay to just a manual switch, you could easily forget and leave the switch on and keep your heated grips or phone charger powered even while the bike's off and you've walked away from it. When picking a circuit to use to trigger the side of the relay, you want to think about what circuit is the least necessary. I wouldn't recommend using like an ECU trigger wire or an ignition wire or a fan relay that has anything to do with the fundamental running of the bike. I would prefer to choose a lighting circuit that isn't absolutely necessary for the bike to run. Thanks for joining me on this theory lesson about how a relay works and why you should use one on your motorcycle. If this helped you out, smash the like and subscribe button down below. And as always, have a good day.